Be still in the presence of the Lord and wait patiently for him to act. Psalm 37, verse 7a.
Be still in the presence of the Lord and wait patiently for him to act. Psalms 37,
verse 7. Be still in the presence of the Lord and wait patiently for him to act. Psalm 37, 7a.
Be still in the presence of the Lord and wait patiently for him to act. Psalm 37, verse 7.
Be still in the presence of the Lord and wait patiently for him to act. Psalm 37, verse 7a.
Be still in the presence of the Lord and wait patiently for him to act. Psalm 37, verse 7.
Be still in the presence of the Lord and wait patiently for him to act. Psalm 37, verse 7a.
Well, good morning, everyone. It is so good to be here with you this Sunday morning, and welcome to you who are watching at home, and welcome to...
Thank you. Yes, good to be here.
It's good to be here. And thank you guys for those of you who took part in our memory verse challenge from 40 days. It was brilliant to see so many there. Linny really pushing the boat out there and taking up the extra challenge of signing. So top marks for you.
Yes.
And also Isla the cat. Very interesting, very observant of you to take on the memory verse challenge.
We didn't have any dogs.
Or cows too.
Yes, of course.
There was room for that.
Missed the trick there.
So next week, continuing with our slideshows, because we do love to see you all. We love to just feature members of our church and people in our community. If you want to join in, please do. So next week, we will be asking you to send in pictures of light, because we're coming up to that time of year where there's different celebrations happening. And as a church, we really like to celebrate the light of this world. So that could be sunsets, sunrises, the way that you see light in your life. But also it's that time of year where the harvest comes in. And we haven't really talked much about harvest yet, have we, Tim?
We haven't. It's kind of almost passed us by, hasn't it, this year? But obviously, as a farmer, we've had a harvest, thankfully.
Exactly. Yeah. And it would be really, really great to have your pictures of things that you may have grown in the garden, things that you're seeing outside that look like a harvest to you, and just to really, really celebrate that time of year.
Yeah. No, definitely. And so we're really thrilled to have you all with us, as Adairan said. And we're so aware that every week we get new people join us. And a special welcome to you if you're new this week, but also a special welcome to you if you've been watching every single week, because we know lots of people have been coming online every single week. And obviously, as a church, we've been in that operation here for 15 or so years now. And so some of you have been on that journey for 15 years. We're going to hear from one person later on who's been with us for 14 years, not quite 15. So today is a really special day, because we want to introduce you to people who are either been great or are great friends of the church and fantastic supporters, and also to people who are new to the church, who have come through our Gear One, and which is our way of introducing people to the church and to Jesus Christ, most importantly. And we want and also the opportunity to come to membership. So we want to welcome in a whole group of people coming into membership this morning as well. So lots of great things have been going on, even during this time of COVID, which I know has been really super tough for so many. But at the same time, God has been working and stirring hearts, and most importantly, drawing people closer to Jesus. And that's what we're about as a church, helping people to find Jesus, isn't it? And, So this morning is a special morning for us, but we want to celebrate this. It's like a celebration, really.
It's kind of like a harvest, Tim.
It is, isn't it?
Isn't that interesting?
Absolutely.
Absolutely. I'm so excited to see and hear a little bit more about these new people. But we're going to open our service in prayer, and then we're going to go straight into our first worship song with Rosie and the team. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for this morning where we can gather round and we can take time away from the noisy, busy world, and we can just be in your presence together as a church, as a community of believers, as a family. And Lord Jesus, we pray that your Holy Spirit will be present in each one of our homes right now, that you will just be very real to us. And as we welcome in new members, new friends, new supporters into our community, that you will bless them, you will encourage them, that they will know that they have found their church home, and that we as a church will gather around them in love, in support, and just that we will be unified through your love, and that we will be a bright light in the community of the Forest of Dean, that we will be able to share your love, share your joy, and share your truth with those around us, and really bring change, really bring a new good that people just aren't aware of into the streets and into the villages and towns and communities of the Forest of Dean. So we thank you for this morning, Lord Jesus. Open our hearts to new members, and just bless this time we have together. Amen.
Amen. Yeah, thank you, Darian. So we're going to go into our first song of worship now. So over to Rosie and the team for our first song. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to week 3 of 40 Days of Waiting. We're back here in the church, and this week we're looking at fellowship and our community. So what better song to sing than Thrive? Will you worship with us now?
Never
and the team for leading us in worship this morning. So we've got a few notices for you now, always that time.
Yeah.
And the first one is going to be about YouTube, again, just as a quick reminder.
Did they not ring the bell?
Oh, I don't know if they ring, you know, they need to ring that bell. Some people did, so thank you so much for doing that. That's really encouraging for us. But of course, you know, please, if you haven't liked our videos, please go and do that. Also subscribe to our channel and then ring that bell, and then you can click on that bell and actually set it to receive all notifications. And that's really, really important, because you'll see when we go live, you'll see when we post up a new video, and it's just really great if you could do that. So please do ring that bell.
Absolutely. Yeah, it's just you're working out, but it's, you've got to just play around with your phones or your tablets or whatever. So tonight we have a really exciting event, because we have our first hour of worship for a while, and it'll be our first one online. So if you'd like to join us, 7:30, you'll need to have a link to the Zoom call. So please just go onto our church members page and pick it up from there, or drop an email to us at admin@fcchurch.co.uk. And I'm sure it will come up on the screen as well, and you can you'll get a link for the Zoom call, so you don't miss out. So 7:30 tonight.
That's really great. Thanks, Tim. Well done. Also, this morning we already started church way before this 10:30, you know, service, because our children's team have already been in their Zoom room for their first pre-service get together. At 10 o'clock every Sunday, our children's groups will be meeting on Zoom with their leaders, and they'll be doing Bible reading, they'll be praying, they'll be learning about why is the Bible relevant to us today, and with all lots of fun and games as well. So if you'd like to get involved with that, please email us here at the church, at admin email again, and Sue and one of her team will be just absolutely delighted to get in touch with you.
Yeah, that's great. So now we're going to have an interview, first of a number of interviews this morning, and it's with a young lady called Yas. And we're really excited because Yas has come to be with us in the church for the next 3 months. She's with First Serve, so it's a mission organisation, and they give young people the opportunity to taste a year of what mission's like. Normally they tend to go abroad into exotic locations. So this year she's going all the way to the exotic location of Cinderford, Forest of Dean. I mean, you can't get better than that, can you? I mean, she comes from right over in the south coast, so she hasn't seen the beauty of our area. So we're glad to have Yas with us, and Lizzie brings this interview with her to us now. Thank you.
Good morning, church. I am really, really excited about this interview, because as a lot of you will know, when I left school, I did a gap year program called First Serve, and it was literally the best year of my life. So I am so excited to announce that we have a First Server in our church for the next few months. Hello, Yas.
Hello.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
So tell us a little bit about yourself. Who are you? How old are you? Where'd you come from? We want to know all the details.
So I'm Yas. I'm 18 and I'm from Eastbourne.
So, what sort of things do you like doing in your spare time?
I absolutely love singing. At my old church, I was a worship leader, and I just absolutely love being Holy Spirit led in everything I do. And I just have such a passion for singing to God and just giving all the glory and praise to Him. It just excites me so much. So I absolutely love doing that. And I love doing like colouring Bible verses. I just love being creative and just that sort of stuff too.
Yeah. Oh, that's so lovely. That's really nice to hear. What are you hoping to get out of your placement here with us? What are you most looking forward to doing?
I'll probably say that I just want to really be Holy Spirit led, like even more so than I am now. I want to just have God's guidance in whatever I'm doing. And I just want to grow my love and my joy for God, really. And just serve Him wholeheartedly in everything I do.
Yeah, that's absolutely awesome. So excited to hear that. Is there anything as a church we can pray for you for while you're here?
Probably pray for my homesickness. because I sometimes still get a little bit homesick from like family and missing my cat too. probably just continuing to settle in and just doing everything that God wants me to do and just being really close to him. That's the main thing.
Awesome. And how long are you here for? I forgot to ask that.
3 months.
Okay, so that's till, can't do math, till the end of January?
Yeah.
Yeah. That is a really long time. I'm so looking forward to you being part of a church, part of our church for this long. And I bet I can speak for the rest of the church. We are so excited to have you here. So thank you so much for coming to this church for your placement. And we so look forward to hearing more about you, getting to know you and the stuff that you'll be doing. So thank you so much for speaking with me.
Thank you so much.
Okay, bye.
Bye.
Well, that was great to have that interview from Yaz. Thank you, Yaz and Lizzie. So now we're going to introduce to you another person who will be very familiar to many people because she's a great friend of our church and has been for many, many years, Kate Wyatt. And it's been lovely to have her support and encouragement. So we thought, as she's often sort of appeared behind the scenes, why not let her come to the camera and introduce herself to you? So I think you do this interview, don't you?
I did, yeah, it was my privilege. So we're going to hear from Kate as our wonderful supporter and friend of Forest Community Church.
Yeah.
So hey everyone, I'm here with Kate Wyatt. Hey Kate.
Hiya.
And it's wonderful to have Kate with us. And Kate is a supporter of our church here at Forest Community. And Kate, you've been attending for a couple of months now, is that right?
Yeah, since the beginning of lockdown.
So another lockdown joiner, which is great. Yeah. So it's wonderful that we've got your support and we've got you attending. And you've also been inputting with your creative pursuits. And it's been wonderful to have you just join small groups as well. And it's really great that just to have you come alongside us as an encourager. Mm-hmm. So, Kate, how long have you been a Christian for?
Well, I was brought up in a Christian family, but I made a commitment myself when I was 18. And I'm 60 in March. So you can work that out, work the maths.
Brilliant, Kate. Oh, that's wonderful. So what drew you to Forest Community Church?
Well, I think initially it was that we sat down the first Sunday of lockdown and we were looking online for services. And I know some people from the church. I knew the church a bit already. So we hunted around. We found yours. We really, really enjoyed the service. And that was it. We were hooked. We joined you almost every Sunday morning since.
Brilliant. So you've seen our craziness develop and as we've moved.
Yeah, you've done a great job. Done a really good job.
Oh, that's brilliant. Oh, it's so good. We have such an enthusiastic team of people who just want to serve the community, and it's been a great outreach for us. So Kate, when we get back together as a full church, you know, when we can actually meet in person again, what do you think that you will be first wanting to get involved with, wanting to be part of in our community?
Well, probably in something that meets the local community around the church, the non-Christians in the community. So something on the fringes that where we can build relationship, where I can help build relationship with the local community. That's usually where my heart has been over the years. So I really mind what I do, but I feel comfortable talking to people and meeting with people and building relationships with people. So,
oh, that's wonderful. Well, we're just really looking forward to seeing how God's going to use you as a supporter of our church. And also, I do know that he has gifted you like with huge creative talents too, so I'm looking forward to utilizing some more of those gifts.
Yeah, no, that's great. I'm always happy to be creative.
Thank you so much, Kate, and it's wonderful to have you join us this morning.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Kate. Really good to hear from you there, and we're just looking forward to seeing more of your creative pursuits as we go forward in the church.
Yeah, absolutely. So we said we're going to be thinking particularly about what it's like to discover God and the Forest Community Church. And we run this gear system, so 1, 2, 3, 4 gears. And the first gear, which we encourage people to come into, is discovering God and the Forest Community Church. And we've done a course back in the summer. And so a number of people have come through that course. We've actually got another load of people waiting to come into that course. Yes. So we're hoping to do gear one again as soon as we get our act together. So if that's you and you would like to be involved in gear one and you haven't done it yet, then please just let us know. Drop a message in an email and we can add you into the team of people. Nikki is brilliant at doing those courses. And so you will enjoy it. It's good fun as well as very informative and helpful. So and part of that process is we give people the opportunity, if they would like to become a member of the church. And so we thought we'd introduce you to a number of these people today. So the first group of people you're going to hear from, there's 5 people and also a little baby. So let's watch. So when did you come to the Forest, Dean?
So we moved on the 6th of March. So about 2 weeks before lockdown happened.
So what attracted you to the Forest City, to the Forest Community Church?
Do you want to answer that one?
So before we moved, we looked on different websites and we were told about the church. And so actually looking online was one of the main things we did. And then we came for 2 visits before lockdown and we liked what we saw.
Surprising. We didn't put you off.
We like the community feel to the church. It's been a very welcoming, a very friendly church. And we love the way you encourage everybody in the church to contribute to what goes on. I think that's one of the things that we value about Forest Community Church.
So what are you doing in the Forest today? What's your plans? What's your vision? What's your dream? What brought you here?
So what brought us here? We love walking and it's a lovely place to live and to walk. What are our plans? We would love to get involved at the church and just be part of your community, I think.
And Sue already is heavily involved. You're involved in the kids' work already, aren't you, Sue?
Yeah.
So you've done a lot of stuff in the past. So you've been doing holiday clubs, yeah?
And yeah, done holiday clubs, Sunday school, all sorts of things, as well as teaching. So, yeah, that's what my background is.
And you enjoy that, don't you?
I love it.
Good.
Hello, I'm Martin. I live in Millwall near Colford.
So you have been in the church just for the few months before. How long were you in before lockdown?
I came just before Christmas was my first time, so we're talking about a couple of months before COVID set in.
Good time.
Yes, yes.
So so you were just starting to get established and then suddenly all the craziness of COVID had come along. So. Yeah, so it's not been easy, has it?
No, I was just beginning to enjoy the church and trying to make friends and I was stopped, so that was unfortunate.
Yeah, so did you come from Bristol originally?
Yes, yeah. I retired here from Bristol 3 years ago to the Forest. And I love it here.
Good.
The people are nice, so yes.
And you enjoy taking your dog out for a walk, don't you?
Yep, got a dog in the summer after COVID started so that I can enjoy the forest even more.
Yeah.
So, yes.
Brilliant. So, what particularly attracted you to the church?
Well, I came here by accident. At the time, I was going to a church in Colford and I wanted a carol service. And you happened to advertise when I was working here on Food Bank.
All right.
And I thought I'd try it. I wanted a more vibrant service and I came here on your carol service in the evening. I was just blown away by the magic of it, I suppose. The children who were singing, just the vibrancy of the service was great and I really enjoyed it. So I thought, well, I must come to a normal service. That's when I started. So yes.
Was it normal?
No, it was very much like Spring Harvest that I'd been going to for years. Mm-hmm. And I wanted that cross-section of people, from youngsters right the way to old people. I could see the vibrancy of the different generations all interacting, because I didn't want to just be in one category. I wanted to see the whole family of people, you know, from the youngsters up. And I just like to see all the youngsters enjoying it as well.
Yes,
so I enjoyed the next service I went to, and I really enjoyed the sermons, which were more applicable to me. They meant more, made me think about God more. So yes, very good.
Good. Good. Okay. Well, I'm not sure what I want to ask you. Welcome.
Thank you. I love it here. Yes, I'm looking forward to coming back when we got normal services and seeing the vibrancy of the church again, which I love.
Yeah.
Yes.
Brilliant.
Hello, Ben and Steph and Ben Haim. Welcome to the church.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Super pleased to have you with us. Now, you've been married for a while.
We have, five years this year.
But you weren't together for all of that time.
We weren't, no. We'd so we met online.
Mm-hmm.
Steph was in Dominican Republic, I was here, and we got together in
last year? In September.
Yeah. So yeah, we've been back together since. So pretty good news.
So that must have been pretty tough.
No. Definitely. Yeah. It's not what either of us was planning, but
we're
still here.
Right. So how long have you been in the Cinderford area?
We moved up toward the end of March, and that's where we just began our search for a local church.
So how are you finding it? It must be really strange living in a new place and not really having met many people in real life.
That's right, yeah.
Yeah.
Like we said before, that, you know, the way in which me and Steph met online is kind of similar to what we're in this situation now. So we're used to that, but it's still weird for church to be that way, that we're kind of connecting with people.
Yeah.
Right. It was really good to meet you both. Just before I let you go, can you tell me one thing that you love about being a Christian?
I would say living by faith and always have hope.
Yeah.
You know, no matter what happens, God is holding us. I would say that.
Brilliant. Even in these strange times.
Yeah. It's like living in peace.
Yeah. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Well, thank you both very much and welcome aboard. We're so pleased to have you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, it was good. We got to hear from, our youngest?
Definitely.
Yeah, fantastic. Really exciting to hear from all these different ones and to hear something on their spiritual journey and what God's doing and how he's drawing them to us. So one of the really important things we like to do and partake in as a church on a really regular basis is communion. Jesus asked us to take bread and wine to remember him and what he had accomplished for us on the cross. And so if you were able to get some bread and wine or juice or whatever with you now, and you can join with us, and Darren and her family are going to lead us in communion. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Vesper and I have the privilege of sharing communion with you this morning. I do hope you're in a quiet space and you're able to just take a moment to reflect with us, to pray with us, and share communion with us. And to start us off, Vesper's just going to share a few reasons why we take communion. Thanks, Vesper.
Communion, or the Lord's Supper, is a special time to remember Jesus. Before Jesus died, he had dinner with his friends, the disciples. He wanted them to remember him. Jesus told them that the bread they were eating was to remind them of his body. The juice they were drinking was to remind them of his blood. Jesus knew he was going to die soon and wanted the disciples to remember his death on the cross. But communion wasn't just for the disciples. It's for all who love and follow Jesus. Believers of Jesus take communion all around the world. We remember Jesus' broken body when we eat the bread. We remember how he bled on the cross when we drink the wine or juice. Communion is a time to remember how Jesus showed his love for us by dying on the cross.
Thank you, Annie. So, in the Bible, in 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 23, on the night when he was betrayed, the Lord Jesus took some bread and gave thanks to God for it. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you. We thank you for your Son. We thank you for your Son, Jesus, the way he came in human form, that perfect babe, and lived a life, a sinless life here on earth, and experienced everything that we do. And then he gave his life in sacrifice for us. We thank you for that. We take this moment to remember his body broken. We take this moment to confess our sins, to bring ourselves humbly before you, to thank you, and to offer you this moment of remembrance and gratitude. Amen. Amen. Then he broke it in pieces and said, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this to remember me." In the same way, he took the cup. He took the cup of wine after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant between God and his people, an agreement confirmed with my blood. Do this to remember me as often as you drink it." Heavenly Father, we thank you again for this ultimate sacrifice. We thank you for the blood spilt on the cross for us, that you were perfect and whole and clean and pure, and we were broken. But through your life, through the giving of your life, we are made whole in God's sight. We thank you. We remember this and praise you for this. Amen.
It was really great to share communion with you this morning. And we're going to continue our service now, guys, with three more interviews.
Three.
Back to back. So it's really, really great that we've got so many people who've just joined us either online or just before lockdown, and just to see how God is moving in their lives and what that has drawn them to Forest Community Church. So we're going to hear from Yvonne, Jane and Dan. And then immediately after that, we're going to go into our prayer time with Nikki, Karen and Nathan. Thanks, guys.
So hi, it's Adairan here. And this morning I have Yvonne with me. Welcome, Yvonne.
Hi.
It's really great that you could join us for this little chat this morning as we welcome you into membership and we just have this moment to get to know you a little bit more. So my first question for you this morning, Yvonne, is how long have you been a Christian? How long have you held your faith?
Since I was a teenager, since I did Sunday school teaching.
It has wavered slightly because of things that have gone on in my life, but I hold it very fast.
Oh, that's brilliant. That's wonderful. Yeah. Where were you a Sunday school teacher, Yvonne?
Ashford in Middlesex and Surrey. And then I lived in Germany for 12 years and I did it while I was stationed there as well.
Oh, fantastic. Mm. So you're not from the Forest of Dean originally then?
No, definitely not. No. Born in India and my home is in Surrey.
Wonderful. What a heritage. And I'm really, really looking forward to hearing more about that. And I'm sure our other members will be as well. So currently you're in Colford, is that right?
Yeah, absolutely.
And you joined our church just before lockdown.
Absolutely, which was rather a shame because I was hoping to get more into the church. And then, of course, it all got cut off.
But you've been following us regularly.
Oh, yeah, I've been following you. I've been following Mr. Tim. And you, young lady.
Oh, that's brilliant. So it's really wonderful that we're going to welcome you into membership this week, Yvonne. And it's just brilliant. I'd love to find out what drew you to Forest Community Church.
I think, first of all, they've done so much for the Forest Food Bank. And, the food bank obviously means quite a lot to me, and I thought, well, they've got to be a good lot if they are prepared to support us and be there for us and do things for the community, which is so important.
It really is. That's good to hear, Yvonne. Yes, the food bank is very dear to our hearts, and yeah, it's a wonderful organisation that supports so many. So we're pleased to support them. Well, that's amazing, Yvonne. And also, it's a sneaky question here. When we get to meet together in person and when we can all join together as a church family, what are your plans? What would be the one thing that you really, really want to get to do and get to, you know, get your teeth
involved within the church? I'd like to be involved with the pastoral care. Very much so, caring about people and making sure they're okay is very, very important to me. And that's obviously come through my work with the food bank as well.
That's
very important. Looking out for people that, you know, just need you to be there.
Excellent. Oh, Yvonne, that's so good to hear. And I really, really am. I want to hear so much more about your journeys and what has led you here. And then we're really looking forward to sharing more and growing more.
And I'm really looking forward to learning more about you when we can all hold hands together again.
Good. That sounds great. Well, thank you so much for your time this morning, Yvonne.
No, it's lovely. Thank you, Ahern. That's really kind of you. And thank you for everything you're doing. It's much appreciated. God bless you all.
And
take care. God bless. Bye.
Hi, Jane. Welcome aboard. We're really pleased to have you in the church.
I'm really pleased to be a part of it.
Now, we, Fiona and I, of course, we've got to get over calling you Miss Evans, which is what we...
Oh, I don't know.
Should we stay with that? So why would that be? Why would we use that name for you?
Because I'm by profession, I'm a teacher, and for a few years I was a head teacher as well, and I've taught all of your children, all of your lovely, lovely boys.
Yeah, and you've done a pretty good job of it. They seem to be doing all right now.
They've turned out all right, haven't they?
Yeah, I think so. So you and I can share the credit, and possibly Fiona gets a bit.
A little bit.
So what are you doing with yourself these days?
Well, as I say, I'm a teacher, but I'm easing myself into retirement now. So I'm not a head teacher anymore. I teach locally for 2 days a week in a local school, and that's just perfect.
And of course, you've been working with the kids in the church already?
Yes, yeah. Strangely enough, I think because I was teaching and with children all the time, when I've been in churches, I haven't done children's work for quite a long time. So, but it's lovely. And I'm looking forward to chatting with them on Sunday as well.
Oh, that's brilliant. Well, thank you. It's fantastic for us that you've leapt in and helped with that before you were even a member.
Oh, well, it's I'm loving being a part of Forest Community Church.
Good morning, Dan.
Good morning, Katrina.
So this morning we are welcoming you into our church membership, along with several other people. So you're actually not new to our church. You have been around for quite a long while. So could you just explain when you came to our church, please?
Okay, so I came when I was 8. I'm convinced it was the end of 2006, and Tim's telling me it's the beginning of 2007, but I know I'm right. And so this has been my home church for nearly two-thirds of my life now. So there you go.
You've managed to survive that long.
I've survived so far.
Well done. You're obviously made of strong stuff. Okay, so can you tell us, obviously during that time, during that journey, you have been away, you've moved away to study. So can you tell us where you went and what you studied, please?
Certainly. So I studied at Oxford and I did PPE, which stands for Philosophy, Politics and Economics, which is even more fun than it sounds. And this is back when PPE was a subject and not personal protective equipment. So in a way, it was a simpler time.
Yes, I'm sure. So you've come home now. And so what are you currently doing?
I'm working for the ONS, Office for National Statistics. So producing statistics. I have been working on COVID response, unsurprisingly enough, I guess that's what everyone's doing at the moment in the office. And we're doing weekly releases on how the economy's doing. The answer is not so great, surprisingly. I guess that's a short version. And today was my last day in that role, and I'm moving to a team in an area called Productivity. So that's going to start. I'm having a week off, and then I'm going to start on that at the beginning of November.
So changes in the offing at the moment then.
Absolutely.
Okay. So as you come into to membership, after you've done the newcomers course and everything, so what is it that you like about our church, can I ask you? So obviously you've had experience of other churches, especially when you were in Oxford studying. So what is it about Forest Community Church that is attractive to you, that you enjoy?
Yeah, so there's a lot of things I could say with this. I've ended up with a bit of a cliche, but I'm going to roll with it. It's how much the church brings people together from completely different walks of life and different stages. So how many completely different types of people we have in our church, the very different kinds of interests and kind of backgrounds they come from. And the church is kind of a thing that brings us all together in a way that I just don't really see how else it would have happened. And I think it's a great demonstration and practice of how the gospel brings people together. And I think that's really cool. So yeah, that's my favorite thing.
Thank you. That's a great answer, I think, because we have got a very diverse church, but somehow or other, God's grace, it works. You know, we just all get along together, which is wonderful. So thank you. Thank you for sharing that with us, and welcome into church membership.
Thank you.
Good morning, church. You join me in prayer. Lord God, we thank you that you welcome us here this morning. Lord God, we thank you that you are the one that welcomes us with open arms. Father, help us to be that expression of love to those around us. Help us to welcome those around us into our lives, into our hearts, into our homes, into our church when we're back together meeting physically like that. But we just thank you that welcoming is so much more than just in person. It's about reaching out, and we can do that in so many ways. Lord, we thank you that in Romans 15:7 it says, so reach out and welcome one another to God's glory. Jesus did it, now you do it. The NLT translation of that is, therefore accept each other just as Christ has accepted you, so that God will be given glory. So we thank you, Lord, that you welcome us because you accept us. And we know too that it's a happy heart that makes our face cheerful, and it's that cheerful face that helps people feel welcomed as well. But our hearts can be cheerful too, because we know that we belong. We know that we're accepted by you, and help us to express that in a really a heartfelt and tangible way, just as Christ accepts and welcomes us. Amen.
Lord, thank you for your beautiful creation. Thank you that you have made us caretakers of all that you have created. You who created us in your image. We pray that you give us the right knowledge and wisdom to look after it effectively and to make sure that for future generations this beautiful earth is still there to enjoy for many, many following generations. Your creation inspires us and it feeds us, it nourishes us physically and spiritually and emotionally. And we pray that this can be enjoyed in the future. You have made us caretakers of this naturally beautiful world. And we pray that the Holy Spirit will help us to continue to look after your creation. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.
Dear Lord, help people in lockdown and those who are sick with COVID. Amen.
Well, it's been so good to welcome some new people to our church, and in Dan's case, not so new, but actually to welcome him into membership this morning. Now, if we were in the building and we're all together, we would have called them at the front and we would have gathered round and we'd all stood to our feet and we would have just prayed for them and stood in our support of them. So we haven't got a luxury today, but yet I think at the same time it's really important we do pray for each of those ones who've committed themselves to the church and to membership and to part of this local church here. So I'm going to pray and give thanks for each one before I move into a very short message. So Heavenly Father, thank you for Richard and for Sue. Thank you for Martin, for Ben and Steph and Ben and Aya, Yvonne, Dan and Jane. Lord, thank you for each one that you've called them to us. Each has had a different journey. They come, but yet they followed your leading and calling upon their lives and want to connect with us as a church and to be part of this expression of the local church, part of the body of Christ here in the Forest of Dean and the Wye Valley, so they can serve and be part of the team reaching out into this community. So I thank you for each one. I pray that you will empower them by your Holy Spirit, that they might be empowered to live well for you and to serve you well in this season of life at this time now. So we ask this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. So, you know, a question that people ask me from time to time is, why has the Forest Community Church grown? From 15 years ago, there were six lovely ladies in their 80s, who sadly, actually, each one of them have passed away now, to the stage where today, that if we were able to meet in the church building, we would be bursting at the seams. And in the 100-year history of the building, there's never been so many people worshipping in that place. So how has it happened? Now, there's lots of things we could say there, but the most important thing is that God, by the power of the Holy Spirit, has been at work. And he has drawn people to himself. He's been changing lives. And we give him the credit, we give him the thanks. And I and each of you part of the church have had the privilege of being kind of having a front row seat on what God has been doing in so many lives. So that's just an absolute pleasure and joy and thrill. And I thank God for it every single day. And that is the bottom line. That is the important part. But there's also other sort of what I would call human elements to this too. And one of the big things is I feel is that the church and, you know, if you've been a part of the Forest Community Church for any length of time, this is you. The church is full of people who are unselfish. You see, it takes unselfish people to grow a church. And as a church, we're kind of the only organization out there in the world today that actually exists for its non-members. Everyone else, they exist for their members. How can we serve our members? How can we get the best value of money for our members? And that's what all these social groups and action groups and different people, you know, whether it's football groups or whatever else it might be, that's what they're all about. But actually, as a church, we're here for the non-members.
Jesus has called us to reach out into our community and to serve our community. And so we're kind of, we as a church, we're a very different organisation to any other organisation out there. And so I've really got two things to say in this very short message. First of all, thank you for being unselfish. Thank you for being unselfish. You know, thank you for being willing to accept change, because none of us, especially when we get a little bit older, find change very easy. And as a church, we've had to change, so even in our fairly short history, so many times, to adapt to things as we've gone along. And yeah, as a church, we've always stepped up. And we've been, just recently even, we've kind of had to move everything online because of the COVID situation, but the church has been able to do that, and everyone in the church has just embraced it. We've even been able to task Aderin with the job of developing our online presence further still, so that more people can connect with us, more people can hear the beautiful good news of the gospel and find Jesus for themselves. And the church, you know, I know, just got right behind it and really want to do that. And that's another change we've been able to bring even the last few weeks. As a church, we don't hold all our money for ourselves. You know, when people give to the church, they give really sacrificially and very generously. And we really value that. But actually, one of the big things, and we will say this up front, is we actually give away at least 20% of our income. So it's not just for ourselves, for running costs. And so every year, thousands of pounds we give away to people around the country and around our world who are serving their communities, so they can bring hope and they can bring help and they can bring the good news of Jesus into their community. So we're a generous church. And of course, we're a church which serves our community. And even this last week, you know, Jonathan Key has been able to go into the local Forest High School and to serve the school there. And we've been able to help him to do that as a church. And he's been able to come in and do some an amazing assemblies. And I know it's really blessed the staff, blessed the children at the school. And of course, so many other things during the beginning of lockdown, we were able to feed some of the most vulnerable children in the community with hot meals. And of course, all the work we're doing with CAP, helping people get out of debt. There's so many other things we could say, which we're serving our community. It's because we're a church at its heart, it's unselfish, full of unselfish people. And we're just wanting to serve and willing to accept change and all that goes with that. So thank you for being unselfish. Thank you for playing your part, even in these difficult days of COVID-19. But then I think the second thing here as a church is we've grown by being welcoming. You see, it's not about us. It's about God, essentially. And we've been a welcoming church. And when you look at Jesus' life, his life is all about his relationship with his Father, but also about other people. You know, that's kind of how we operated. It's all about his relationship with God and relationship with others. And I guess it was exemplified at the cross. You see, as Jesus was at the cross, at that most painful hour for him, as he went through the agony of dying on the cross, when you think, well, he might just be forgiven for thinking about himself a little bit. But yet, of course, on the cross, one of the things that the conversations he literally had at the cross, there was a person dying either side of him who knew they deserved to be there. They were criminals. And one of those people at the cross turned to him. And in Luke's gospel and chapter 23, the criminal there, he said that we deserve, in verse 41, we deserve to die for our crimes, but this man hasn't done anything wrong. Then he said to Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Remember me when you come into your kingdom. What was Jesus' response? Jesus' response was this: I assure you, today you will be with me in paradise. I assure you, today you will be with me in paradise. I mean, what a saviour we have. Someone that, in that moment of excruciating pain, as he was dying the most painful death that mankind has dreamt up, to kill another person, he was able to think of the dying faith on his side and welcome him into heaven. And that's why we as a church seek to be welcoming. And that's what we are wanting to do, and we seek to do every single day, to just to be welcoming and to follow the example of Jesus. You see, that thief knew that they deserved the punishment, but yet they were still allowed to come into heaven because they trusted in Jesus to forgive them for their sins. And so, you know, as a church, we are like that. We want to open our arms up and to welcome everyone. No one is too bad to come to God. No one is too bad to come to church. Often people say to me, well, I want to get my life sorted out, I'll come. No, that's the wrong way around. You come now as you are. And if you're watching this today and thinking, I'd like to be involved in that community, I'd like to be part of it, but you can't quite get the courage up, well, come, connect with us, drop us a message. You know, people message me all the time, and we'd love to meet with you. Because, you know, it doesn't matter about your background, doesn't matter about your history, doesn't matter how old you are, doesn't matter about your status in life, you are welcome. And as Dan said earlier on in the his clip was talking about coming into membership, you know, one of the things he loves about the church is the fact that it's such a diverse place. Everyone is welcome. And maybe you wanted just to connect with us and you want to come through Gear One, you know, to discover more about God and the Forest Community Church. Well, that's a great place to start. And I would encourage you, sign up for that. And we'll be running one soon. So take the opportunities, because we are a welcome church and we love you to be part of what God's doing across the Forest of Dean and the Wye Valley. So let's just pray. Father, thank you that you're a God who welcomes us regardless of who we are. Thank you that even on the cross, Jesus welcomed that dying faith into heaven. And so thank you for the way you reach out to us and help us as church members in these strange times of COVID to welcome those all across who come into our path so that they might find something of the joy of Jesus in their lives. Amen. So Rosie's going to lead us in our last song. So thank you, Rosie.
Please worship with us now as we sing Good, Good Father.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Rosie, for leading us in worship there and the rest of the team. Well, what a morning, Tim.
Yes.
It's amazing to see how so many people have just been drawn to the church, being drawn closer into relationship with God. And it's such a blessing. And we'd just like to say, you know, if there's anyone out there who's watching, and I know some people just watch quietly, and it can be quite intimidating to get in contact with a new church and to kind of make those first steps. But seriously, we are who you see. And we would just love to connect with you. So if you'd like to just touch base with one of the team members, so with Tim or myself, or someone else that you feel that you might have a connection with, then just drop us a line at either our emails, which will come up on the screen now, or you can call the church, the numbers are there, and we'd be really, really happy to hear from you.
Yeah, definitely. I hope you feel that we are that welcome church, and it's an easy place to connect with. That's what we're about. So let's just pray and give thanks to God and commit ourselves to Him just before, with one or two reminders at the end after I pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this morning. We thank you for the joy of welcoming new people into the church, for being able to see on screen some great friends of the church, and like Kate, and also Yaz, who've been able to come alongside us as a church, and we pray your blessing on them, but also those who have come into membership. Lord, we thank you for them, and we thank you for their heart, for your kingdom, for their heart for you, and their desire to know you more and to serve you more, and to connect with your body here in the Forest of Dean and the Wye Valley, and to be part of your team here, serving you together. And so we thank you for the privilege of not, Lord, you don't leave us alone, but you put us in a team so that we can encourage each other. And Lord, we know that we're always more effective when we're working in a team. And so, Lord, I pray for each one watching this morning. Perhaps some feel isolated, some feel disconnected because of all that's going on with coronavirus at the moment. And Lord, I pray that they wouldn't sense something of your presence with them wherever they are, something of your encouragement. And Lord, I pray that they will know that they're not alone, because not only are you close to them, but Lord, they're joined to us, even if it's via the internet and the technology, Lord. And there's that sense of being together in Christ. And so we thank you for this. And Lord, I pray that it will take us forward this week, and Lord, guide our steps, lead us in every way, so we might honour you and please you in everything that we do and say. For your glory we ask. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Tim. And it's been really great to be with you here this morning to share with you. And it's not over yet, guys. So the service here on YouTube has finished, but we will be jumping over onto Zoom now for our after church coffee and chat. So bring your cup of tea, bring your coffee, bring your cake, Nigel, of course. And we look forward to seeing you soon. Cheers, guys. Bye for now.
Yeah, bye.